What's up internet, I'm Manish from RebellionRider.com and welcome back once again. This is the third tutorial in the tablespace in Oracle database series. And today we will learn how to create a temporary tablespace. The process of temporary tablespace creation is quite similar to that of the permanent tablespace that we discussed in the previous tutorial. So I suggest you to watch it if you haven't already. You can find the link for the same in the description box. So without wasting much of your time, let's start the tutorial. Before moving ahead, just want to tell you that all the create tablespace DDL which we have done in the previous tutorial or which we will be doing in today's tutorial are command line compatible. This means that you can write them on your command or shell prompt and they will work fine. That said, let's continue. First, I will connect to my database using the sysuser with sysdb privileges. Okay, here we are. Let me quickly confirm you the user. User is sys. Next, we will write our create tablespaces statement to create a temporary tablespace. A temporary tablespace is used for temporary segments, which are created, managed, and dropped by database as needed. These temporary segments are commonly generated during sorting operations such as order by, group by, and create index. They are also generated during other operations such as hash join and insert into temporary tables. Similar to that permanent tablespace, you can create a temporary tablespace either as small file or big file tablespace. So let's write the DDL and see how to create a temporary tablespace. Okay, let me first close this script output. Okay, now let's quickly take a look at this create tablespace DDL. Statement starts with create and tablespace, both of which are Oracle reserved keyword. In between these two keywords, we have another keyword which is small file, which specifies that we want to create a small file tablespace. By the way, this is an optional keyword. If you don't write this, then Oracle is gonna create a small file tablespace by default. Next, we have the name of the tablespace, which is temp_rebellionrider. This name is user defined, so you can give whatever name you want to your tablespace. Then there is a temp file clause. Unlike permanent tablespace where we have data file clause, here we have temp file. Temporary tablespaces are created using temp files instead of data files. Temp files are allocated slightly differently than data files. Whereas data files are completely allocated and initialized at creation time, the temp files are not always guaranteed to allocate the disk space specified. This means that on some Unix system, a temp file will not actually allocate disk space until a sorting operation requires it. Although this delayed allocation approach allows rapid file creation, it can cause problems down the road if you have not reserved the space that may be needed at runtime. Here, I have only added one temp file to our temporary tablespace, which is temp_rebel.dbf, the size of which is 100 MB. Next is extent management clause, where I set it on uniform mode with size 1 MB. Unlike permanent tablespace, segment space management clause is not available with temporary tablespace. Execution of this query will create a small file temporary tablespace. So let's execute. Okay. Here we got ORA02180 Oracle error. This is because in this command we haven't specified what kind of tablespace are we creating. Right, while creating a temporary tablespace, we have to tell the Oracle engine that we are creating a temporary tablespace. And to do the same, we have to write a mandatory keyword which is temporary right before the keyword tablespace. So let's write it. Let me also close this script output. Okay, you just have to write this temporary, which is a keyword, right before the tablespace keyword. Okay, everything is set. Let's try executing this query once again. As you can see, small file temporary tablespace is created. That's the recipe for baking a small file temporary tablespace. You see how easy it is? Now, what if you want to create a big file temporary tablespace? Let's create one. Just to save the time, I will copy this whole create tablespace DDL and will modify it accordingly. By the way, I will share this script with all these statements and you can find the link either on my blog or in the description box. So let's write it. Okay, before that, let me close this script output. Okay, now let's go ahead. Okay, done. Now I will modify this. As we are creating a big file tablespace, thus first we need to change this small file keyword to big file keyword. Always remember to specify the keyword big file if you want to create a big file tablespace. It's mandatory in case of big file tablespace creation. Next, we have to change the name of our temporary tablespace to, let's say, temp_rebellionrider. Okay, perfect. Similar to data file, a big file tablespace can only have one temp file as we have here. If in case we have already added more than one temp file to a temporary tablespace, then we have to delete them. Similar to the name of the tablespace, we have to change the name of the temp file. As we know that no two temp file can have similar name. That's why we have to change the name of our temp file from temp_rebel.dbf to temp2_rebel.dbf. Let's do it. Perfect. Rest of the clauses are fine and we are all set to execute this DDL and to create our big file temporary tablespace. So let's execute. Big file temporary tablespace created. See, isn't it simple? That's it for today. Comment your feedback and feel free to follow me on Twitter and other social media. All the links are in the description box. You can also read about the same topic on my blog. The link is in the description box again. If you like this video, then please hit the thumbs up button. And yes, don't forget to hit that big red button and subscribe to my channel. We'll see you soon. Till then, take care. This is Manish from Rebellion Rider.